Hello everyone and welcome to Online Learning Center. My name is Suraj and I'm the instructor and founder at OLC. So I have around 10 years of experience in IT and I have been working on data engineering projects since last 8 years. Some of the companies which I have worked with includes Capgemini, United Health Group, Credit Vidya, Prokarma, Apple, and currently I'm working as a senior data engineer at Cloud Untitled USA. So I started mentoring a lot of students and working professionals in the field of data engineering since 2014. So you can see our YouTube channel has some of the oldest video from 2015. Let us understand what program we have brought for you guys. Okay. So if you look into my screen, I've just designed everything, put everything, every possible things together so that it can help me to understand, explain you much more better. So we have an exclusive 10 months of program, and trust me, you don't find this anywhere else. So our 10 months of program is designed in such a way that even a guy with no idea on programming can master the data engineering program. How much time it could take? It could take almost 250 hours. Now it is up to you how fast you can finish it off. Let's talk about the course. So we have divided this course into two parts. I call it Data Engineering 1 and Data Engineering 2. Now, Data Engineering 1 starts with the basics fundamentals of Java programming. We will be learning Java for a month, followed by a lot of problems to help you improve your skills in Java programming. Okay. Now, after this, we'll be learning MapReduce in great details. Why? Because that will help you to improve your thinking capabilities in a big data perspective. Done. Now we'll have Hive for 23 hours. We'll have Scoop for 6 hours. HBase 10 hours. Oozy for 4 hours. This whole course will also cover the Linux wherever required, as well as SQL commands in our Hive session. Now, in this whole DE1 program, we'll do one project. And that project is really a very, very complicated project, which you cannot solve just by using Hive. We will have to write a lot of customizing code that will, wherein you'll write a lot of MapReduce stuff and then get the work done. So the whole agenda of this program is to help you make ready for DE2 program. Now let's talk about DE2. So DE2 course is 130 hours and we have covered everything in detail. So we have Spark, we have Scala, we have Kafka, we have Elasticsearch as our main components, right? So Scala we will be learning for 60 hours. And trust me, Scala is very, very important, and you cannot learn Scala in just a week of program, right? So you will have to master this program, because after the course, you're going to put at least 3 years of work experience. If you want to claim that, then you have to be pro in Scala programming. So Scala and Java is so much required. Now, after this Scala is done, we'll move to Spark, where we'll cover a lot of modules on Spark. Talk about Spark Core in detail. We'll talk about Spark SQL data frames, Spark Streaming, Spark GraphX. Okay, we will not cover Spark ML in this program. Now we have Kafka, we have Elasticsearch, and these two are also very, very important. Now, the DE2 course will also cover something called cloud. Okay, so we have included AWS, where we will talk about EMR, EC2, Redshift, Athena, Glue, and S3. And then we have Airflow, another scheduler, just like your Uzi, which we will cover in DE2 program. And once you're done with this DE1 and DE2, you may be interested to look into the job, right? So I would say we have another section, a small section called Fundamental of Data Structure and Algo, wherein we will talk about the basic data structure and algorithms which can help you to get ready for our product-based companies. Every good company would basically trick you with data structure and algorithm problems, and you need to understand this. So we will just get started, and then we have a separate blog section where we have a lot of students contributing the questions on data structure and algorithm, and we all will solve it together. As part of this DE2, you are going to work on 3 different projects. And what are these 3 different projects? I will take my previous work experience, right? So what we'll do, we will just simulate the data set, keeping the requirement same as it is. And once you're done with this project, you can put the same project as it is in your resume. We are not going to talk about Uber analysis, Ola analysis, YouTube analysis, Titanic analysis, fraud analysis, this analysis, that analysis. We would be doing something which I have already done. The same requirement I'll create for you guys. You'll work on this project. The reviews, the code would be reviewed and would be the feedback would be given so that you can improve. So once you're done with this D2 program, you should be able to work on these three projects very, very easily. Now, once DE1 is covered, once DE2 is completed, you can now apply for a job in any companies, right? So we have a lot of students who have got a job with JPMC, with Walmart, with PayPal, with L&T Infotech, Tavan Technologies, EY, and so on. So we have a students in product-based companies, we have a student in service-based companies, and they are all really paid really good. So I would suggest you to go through our success stories and you will find more success stories there. Now, what is the unique thing about this platform, right? So we have a detailed program on DE1 and DE2. Now see here, we have included Java for 32 hours. Now, I know that you may have a question, do I really need to know Java, right? So let us understand one thing, that all the big data products like Apache Hadoop, Apache Scoop, Apache Hive, Apache Edgebase, and so many stuff are all written in Java. And in the real time, when you are working for a company, it's not like you just write a Hive queries. You will have to write some integration logic. For example, how do I make my Java program interacting with a Hive? Or how do I write my Kafka producer and consumer in probably Java? Okay, or how do I write my Elasticsearch client and expose it to a REST service, again using Java? So the Java knowledge is very, very important if you want to get into a good companies on data engineering roles. So I don't say that people are not working on Python. They are also working on it, but I'm telling you my experience, all my 8 years of experience into data engineering were all on JVM-based platforms. And that's the reason we are covering everything from end to end. Now, let's talk about a couple of more stuff I know, which is a common question from everyone. We have listed it down here. About me, I have already covered. Now, we have also covered about the courses we are offering. We are offering D1 and DE2. This goes for 120 hours, 4 or 5 months. D2 goes for another 130 hours, 4 or 5 months. So, in minimum, you need a 10 months of effort. Okay. Now, who should join DE1 program? If you do not have any exposure on data engineering, you have no clue what a big data does, then you should go with DE1 first. Okay. However, we get a lot of students, we get a lot of working professionals who says, so I have been working on data engineering one for quite a long time. I have been using Hive, Scoop, Edgebase at my job. I have worked a little bit on Scala and Spark, but not in detail. What should I do? In that case, I would say you can happily skip this DE1 and you can directly jump into DE2 program, because this will also take at least 5 months, right? Now, how about the freshers? This is a very important question, right? I'm a fresher, should I join your course, right? I would say it is always good to take the course as soon as possible. The reason is because today you are fresher, tomorrow after 6 months, 1 year, 1.5 years, 2 years, you will not be a fresher. The course is going to help you shaping your career and future. We have seen around 10 out of 10 freshers are mostly doing data science, right? And the biggest problem is in data science, you have a lot of people who are doing data science and the requirement is really small. But if we talk about data engineering, that is really opposite. In data engineering, you have a lot of requirement, a lot of companies are hiring, but we do not have a good resource. The reason is because people are not learning it in detail. And that's the reason the whole curriculum is designed to make sure that you are learning from one end to the other end. Okay. So as a fresher, you can also take this program if you are a fresher, because today you are a fresher, but this knowledge, this transition of 1 year of program will take you a lot of years ahead, right? And you would be equivalent to anyone working in the industry for 3 to 4 years, because I will be covering everything in detail so that you understand everything. Now, what is the prerequisite for this program? No prerequisite at all, because I know that if I say that you must know these and that, then it would be very hard for you to learn those. How are you going to learn? There are so many platforms available in the market, right? There are so many YouTube lectures, lessons, channels and all, but the problem is you do not have a step-by-step path. The road map is not available. Everybody would say do this, do that and whatnot, but it takes a lot of time for somebody to help you towards the journey, right? So there is no prerequisite because we are taking care of everything, whatever you should do here. Next, I have a career gap. What should I do, right? So if you have a career gap, you are not working on IT since 2 years, 3 years, right? One or other day, you are going to work on IT, right? Somehow, it's not it. So why not take this opportunity to complete the D1 and D2 program and make yourself industry ready. There are companies who are hiring people with a good, decent skills. Of course, I will not talk about the big companies, but there are small companies who says, if you have people who are freshers or who have gap, but they are well equipped with the technology, then we will be hiring it. For example, anyone who is doing consulting, it does not matter. If you are able to deliver it to the client, then it really does not matter. So if you have a career gap, then you should also consider taking this program. Now, doubt solving, right? So let me tell you, the DE1 program is now completely a video-based platform, okay? So D2 is a program which I'm going to start from 20th June 2021, right? And after that, this DE2 program will also be a self-paced program. You may say, hey, your self-paced program versus some other live training, what would be the difference? Trust me, producing this much big content is really not possible for anybody. And the good point is all our classes will be completely live, whiteboard session. I'll be teaching you on the board. I'm not going to do the PPT readings. Okay. So all the concepts would be taught on the board. I'll share my screen. I'll show you the practical. That's how we will be doing a live session. Okay. Or the recorded sessions, right? So even though you are taking our recorded session, I can give you a guarantee that this would be much more better and efficient than anything else. We have a lot of people coming to us from different platforms. Says, Suraj, I have taken a course from XYZ place paying 1.5 lakh rupees. Says, Suraj, I have taken a course on data science data engineering paid 4 lakh rupees. I paid 8 lakh rupees, right? So we wanted to make it really reasonable, right? And then we said, okay, we will be creating a course which would be very, very pocket friendly and you should be in a position to take this program. Okay. Now, doubt solving, if you're taking our recorded session, then anytime you are stuck, feel free to WhatsApp me and I'll be helping you out with the queries. We have a dedicated group of 140 plus people, right, who have taken our DE2 course already, and they're already in a group. So what we do is any doubts whenever you have in future, you can post your doubts on the WhatsApp group and our experts are going to help you. We have a lot of people who took a course from me 4 years, 5 years ago, and now they themselves have 4 years of working experience in data engineering. Okay. Now, efforts required. How much time it will take for me to become a master in data engineering? Number one, as you see, the course is a 10 months long program for working professionals. Okay. So if you are free, if you are a fresher, you do not have a job, you can definitely reduce this 10 months to probably 5 months. Okay. But what I'm assuming is 99% of the students or the audience that joins our program are all working professionals, right? And then we want a commitment from you that you should spend at least 2 hours a day. Okay. So 2 hours a day is what I basically recommend you to spend time every day, 2 hours a day. All right. Or let's say 14 hours a week. If you are not available because of some reason at certain point of time, then try to work on the weekends. So try to make sure that you are working at least 14 hours a week so that the course can be completed very smoothly. Next, demo. Right? You may say, hey, I understood and I love your program. I understood what exactly it takes to be a data engineer, right? Because see, I have been doing a data engineering since 8 years. I know the length and breadth of the program, right? Many trainers teach you for 30 days. Many trainers teach you for 5 hours. You get a lot of varieties. Everybody has their own curriculum. We have our own curriculum, right? And I know what it takes to become a real data engineer, right? So you may say, hey, can I get some demo and can I see how well you teach? We're very proud to say that we have an offering of around 42 plus hours of demo. Okay, trust me, nobody gives you this demo because everybody would say, pay me first, then get the access. Otherwise, no. We don't want to do that. We want you to see our program. Try our program for 42 hours. Seriously, you try for 42 hours. All the videos would be all white board based. We will not be using screen recording systems, right? No PPTs, no screen recording systems, concepts on the board and examples on the screen. So we have a 42 hours of demo, right? We may increase it, we may decrease it, but right now we have 42 hours of demo. Feel free to start with a demo program, learn the fundamentals and decide. But I will not suggest you to complete this 42 hours and then decide. I will suggest you to go through a couple of videos, 4, 5, 10 hours. And once you feel this is the right place, immediately join. Because unless you don't pay, you will not be serious. Trust me, that does not work. You will lose interest somewhere and then you cannot make it big. Okay. Next, fee and EMI. What is the fee of this DE1 course? What is the fee of this DE2 course, right? So I would suggest you to look into the description of this video where I have given a link to fee and the EMIs. The only reason why we don't talk about it here is because the fee changes along with the content. Tomorrow, if this course goes to 200 hours, then the fee gets changed. If this course gets reduced by 40 more hours, the fee gets reduced. So fee and EMI, please check the description. We have given a FAQ and you will find all the details in that particular place. Job reference. So as I've told, we have a lot of people, our internal students working on data engineering since a long, long time, right? And whenever there is a requirement in their own company, like Walmart, JP Morgan and all, they would basically post us internally and we will help you getting placed. But provided you have to finish this DE1 or DE2 program completely, finish up all these three projects as well, right? So that's the commitment I would like you to give it to me. Okay, now interview preparations. We are happy to say that we are the only platform where you will see the interview questions of 200 plus real interviews. Okay, what we did is we asked all the people to contribute to our platform. So all these interview questions are not man-made interview questions like people do, right? But these are all the questions contributed by the people who went to the interviews, right? So as a once you're done with this DE2 program, once the course is completely over and once you have completed your review, we will give you access to the 200 plus interview questions. And by the time you take this course, maybe these 200 companies may get increase to 300 or 400, right? So we are still accepting a lot of entries and I'm sure we are going to make it big. Now, the next is success stories and feedback. What our students say about us, right? So I would say, please check our Facebook page. Please check our Google reviews to understand how our students have rated our course, right? And that is very important. We chose Facebook earlier because we wanted to make it as genuine as possible. Click on any user and then you will be able to see if that user's profile is complete or fake, right? So now we've recently moved to Google. So we have close to 240 plus reviews on Facebook and we have close to 70 plus reviews on Google. We started Google review recently, okay? But earlier we were using Facebook platform. All right. So I hope I have explained you everything about our program, DE1 and DE2. And trust me, guys, it takes a lot of time. Please do not waste your time and energy, doing some self-study here and there, because it takes a lot of time to understand all these things, right? I put a lot of energy and efforts in building this program, and this is basically the result of my 8 years of experience put together. So now, as I've told, our platform also has a concept of what? Interview questions, right? And we also have a hackathon. You please check the link in the description. I have specified everything in detail. 200 plus companies interview questions exclusively for our learners. We have a hackathon, some public hackathon, but a lot of premium hackathons. And all these hackathons contains the real time coding interview questions, whatever me or our students or anybody else has faced during the interview. So the hackathon is designed in such a way that you should be able to solve any problem using either Spark, using either MapReduce, using either Hive, and so on. Then we have a blogging sections. where a couple of our students have contributed to solve the problems. And trust me, problem solving is the only key that can take you to a good product-based companies. By just learning DE1 and DE2, you cannot get into a good product-based company. A product-based company would always test your skills on data structure and algorithm and problem-solving skills. So we focus it a lot, right? In as part of this Java program, we have a lot of problems to solve so that you can become better every day. All right. We are also going to learn a lot of tools, developer tools like Log4j, JUnit, Maven, of course, SBT here, Scala with SBT, and SonarQube, Git, Eclipse, and IntelliJ shortcuts, and few more. Okay. So we are also going to cover all these tools which are actually used in our development. For example, let's say you are building a big data project, right? At the end of the day, you may create a lot of high-view DFs. You may write some Java-based client to connect to Elasticsearch. You may write some Kafka producer and consumer, and all of this would go to a Git. That's not it. Now, all these things, if you see, are not covered as part of big data course. And that is the reason we never say our course is a big data course. Our course is a data engineering course. So whatever I've done at my work, I would be basically putting them so that anybody who is completing this program should be able to successfully work in the company, right? Now, Eclipse and IntelliJ shortcuts, why do you really need that? So let's talk about Eclipse and IntelliJ shortcuts. So Eclipse or IntelliJ are basically what we use on a daily basis if you are a hardcore developer in data engineering, right? So suppose you are given a requirement, you have written some code, you have pushed the code, and then your code is running now, right? And then let's say the code has given an error at line number 55 of demo.java present on P1 package, let's assume. So now you will have to quickly locate that P1 package, demo.java line number 55. In a real time, you'll have so many packages, there are so many classes, how would you even quickly locate it, right? So you just say Control Shift R and then search the class name, done. You get the class name, Control L, go to the line number, hit enter, and there you go. So likewise, there are so many Eclipse shortcuts. You have to master it because you cannot claim yourself an experience and then look about how do I get into this place, right? So all these things will also be covered as part of the program. So I hope we understood what exactly OLC has to offer you, right? Now, I would suggest that before you take up a program, maybe with OLC or maybe with anybody else, try to look for few points. Number one, demo. Okay, because just one demo will not be sufficient, right? A single demo cannot help you. So ask the instructor, can you give me 10 to 15 hours of session? I want to understand what exactly you are teaching, because only after watching 10 to 15 hours, you'll be able to understand the quality of the program. Okay, so we are offering you 42 hours of program to help you understand what exactly we do. Second thing is ask them for the projects. How many projects are you going to give me? Are you going to give me only one? Are you going to give me two? Are you going to give me 10? And if at all, what kind of project is that? Is that something which I can put on my resume? Or is that something which is just a POC out of the data set available in the internet? Most of the time you get only POC, and that will not help. I get a lot of requests from the students saying that, Suraj, I wanted to take in the program all this stuff somewhere else, but only thing now I need is the project. Can you just give me a project? And I say, I cannot give you the project because these projects are not so easy. It is a very complicated project. It takes a lot of time and effort to solve. And I believe if you do not have a great understanding on Scala, because you have just taken Scala for 5 hours or 7 hours, then you will not be able to finish this project. I have worked with most of the product-based companies. I worked with Apple, where I was working on developing maps for the whole world, right? So I worked with a company like Credit Vidya, where we were dealing with
SMS processing and getting something out of it. So we will be doing something very, very similar, right? So we do not have the data, we do not have a real-time data, but I still have the idea, right? So what we'll do is, whatever I have done in my previous work, I'll just know the idea, we will create the dummy data set, and we will have the same idea, we'll stick to the idea and we'll work on that project. So project is the second thing. Number third, you should ask them, how are you going to help me in the interviews? Do you have some interview questions? What we have is, we have our 200 plus companies interview questions, and they're not cooked up by me, right? It is given, it is contributed by people like you. So that's very important. Interview questions. Number four, ask them, can you give me reference, job reference? This is very important, right? And personalized support. So there are so many platforms where if you want to ask a question, you just have to create a ticket and you never know who is going to answer your queries. So please make sure that you are learning it from people who is actually doing, right? So the last question what you should ask is, where do you work? If the trainer is not working, if he's just a trainer, then trust me, he will not be able to help you a lot in the real time. What happens after you are done with the course? You are stuck in something, a real stuff, right? A real problem. Will he be able to solve their problem? No, because he has never done it. He just learned it from somewhere. So make sure that you are basically, you know, like looking into all this stuff before you take up the program anywhere. And one of the most important thing you should basically ask is Java required? Many people will try to say, no, Java is not required. Even if you're not from programming background, you can take up the course. I'm also saying the same. Even if you're not from programming background, you can still take up my course because I'm going to teach you everything, right? But then if you don't see the curriculum has included Java, then it is really a big red flag, because big data has a lot of openings. Search it in the LinkedIn, you'll find a lot of jobs in big data. Okay. Now the question is, you are from a non-development background, you were doing some SQL queries, you were doing some mainframe stuff, you were doing some support project, nobody would offer you a handsome salary by just learning a course, right? You'll have to learn everything. People will hire you for logic, okay? And logic will come only with a programming language, okay? So the college level of knowledge may not be helpful, because we all know how much we have learned in the college, right? Mostly we don't study a lot, most of the people, right? So including me, of course, right? So we don't learn a lot. The real learning happens when you jump into the company. So I hope you understood what exactly our 10 months of program has to offer you. Now, if you have any queries, you can definitely let me know in the comment section, and I'll definitely reply you guys. You can reach out to me on WhatsApp and I can definitely help you out to solve any of your queries. So our course is going to start on 20th of this month, that is DE2. It's going to be live program. And what we're going to do is, initially, the 15 hours of Scala and 10 hours of Spark, we are inviting everybody to join our 25 hours of program absolutely free, okay? You want to see the quality, you want to see my whiteboard teaching, you are free to join and enroll in this program. And I have also given the link to register in the comment section. Please enroll there and then let us take it forward. Okay, so let's discuss one more thing. How much salary can I get, right? So this is a very common question asked by everyone, right? Okay, I take your course, but tell me, what is the return of investment? How much am I going to get out of it? So I'll say the salary can always be calculated like this. If I say I have 5 years of experience, then you do into 3, and that is 15 LPA minimum, okay? So I say always stick to a figure of N into 3, where N is basically your number of experience. We have a student who have around 5.5 years of experience, and he was able to get 30 LPA. We are going to interview him as well, and you will see them in our YouTube channel section, right? But then the numbers can be anything. So we have a lot of success stories where people are making more than 20, 25 at least, right? And that's what it would be. So the return of investment would be very, very good, right? And then the biggest reason is because the DE1 and DE2 course are completely in detail. Okay, so we are not missing out anything. You'll get access to the notes, you'll get access to all the videos, right? And anytime we update our content, you'll get the updated material forever. That's the biggest advantage of taking a course at OLC.
And I'll suggest you, before you join to any platform, try to do a research. Talk to the instructor. Ask them, do you teach Java? Do you teach Cloud? Do you teach Scala for 2 months? Because the Scala is so much important. Why are you not teaching it for 2 months? You ask about how much you are going to talk about Spark. You ask about the projects. What kind of project is that? Is that a real-time project? Can I put it on my resume? If yes, then how many? And most importantly, ask the instructor, do you work somewhere? If no, then probably you will be missing a lot of real-time stuff, because we put a lot of effort. We spend 8 hours, 10 hours debugging the code, understanding the code, right? And that is how you get an experience. You will miss this if you're learning it only from people who are trainers. Okay, all right, guys. So that's all I have from my side. And I hope you understood this. Let's meet. We'll look forward for the sessions.